Okay, we got somebody on the phone. I think it's hello. Who's on the phone? Who do I got on the phone here? Hello.
Greetings, Jimmy. It's me, Mitt Romney.
I'm sorry. Who is
you
this?
Remember me? I ran for president back in 2012. I lost.
Oh, sure. I remember you. How you doing, Mitt?
Yeah. Well, could be better. I'm wondering where my purpose in life is. I used to think I was the one that prophecies foretold. I would become the first Mormon president of the United States, thus bringing the world together under the Latter-day Saints revelations.
Well, I guess I can see why you would be disappointed, buddy.
I thought I was Neo in the Mormon Matrix.
Well, you're not.
I'm still a bishop.
Yeah, you are.
Jimmy, you may call me Your Excellency.
Don't think so, Mitt. Listen, what have you been doing with yourself these days?
To start with, for starters, I was on Meet the Press last Sunday.
Uh-huh.
That night, David Gregory asked me about Iraq.
Yeah.
I don't understand why people say he doesn't connect with audiences. I found him electric and charismatic.
You might be the only one, Mitt. My question to you is, why the hell were you asked on Meet the Press anyway?
As a multimillionaire who doesn't hold elected office, it is important the country heed my opinions. Meet the Press thought it was important that there's at least one pro-war voice in the anti-war mainstream peace-stick media.
Okay. Well, listen, what do you think we should do in Iraq, Mitt? Tell me that.
Hello?
Yeah. What do you think we should do?
Oh, yes. I agree with Senator McCain and the other Republicans. This is Obama's fault for leaving Iraq. We won the war thanks to the surge. The surge worked. That's why we need to go back to Iraq.
Okay.
Obama should have acted in Syria to take down the Shiite forces, which would have prevented Sunni forces from taking over Baghdad. And our alliance with Iran would defeat the Iraqis, stopping their nuclear program, spreading freedom and democracy, putting boots on the ground but letting Iraqi forces take over, not negotiating with terrorists, and stabilizing the region.
You know, Mitt, nothing you or the other Republicans are saying about this makes any sense whatsoever.
I look forward to hearing the options that the president is considering so I can oppose them.
I bet.
Military action is always the answer. More war makes any situation better.
Yeah, listen, Mitt, you know, I don't think America can make this situation better.
When we topple Malachi, we'll mm-hmm. be greeted as liberators. The war will pay for itself. We got to fight them over there so we don't fight them over here.
Mitt, you're repeating the same insane talking points that you had the first time in the run-up to the war.
The sequel is always better. My definition of sanity is doing the same thing over and over again until you get the result you were expecting.
I don't think that's that. Listen, I heard Paul Wolfowitz say that what's happening in Iraq is not a sectarian conflict, that it's Al-Qaeda, ISIS forces, and everything going wrong is because of Al-Qaeda?
That wise Mr. Wolfowitz has never been wrong before. All of our enemies are Al-Qaeda. Syria is Al-Qaeda. Putin, he's Al-Qaeda.
What?
The waiter at Masa who got my order wrong? Al-Qaeda.
You know, I don't think anything you're saying is correct, Mitt, at all. Nothing.
I assure you, Jimmy, if I were president, none of this would be happening.
You know, Mitt, I've always wondered, what does a person like you, with hundreds of millions of dollars, what do you do for fun?
Well, I have hobbies. At night, I like to go out and key people's cars.
Wow, really?
Jimmy, I need to go make one of my servants cry.
Oh, okay. Well, listen, Mitt, I appreciate you checking in with us. Thanks, buddy.
Oh, this may be the last time I call.
Why?
Thanks to TV and newspapers wanting my opinions, I'm relevant again. So I don't need to talk to you anymore.
Well, just the same, Mitt, I appreciate you calling in. It's always good to hear your voice, okay?
Go stick your dick in the shredder, you gaping-ass Irish cockroach. Just like the old times. I like it.
Okay.